Hey there, I'm Allie Astrocyte, and this week on NeuroTrans-
Hey, Allie, there's actually a Pokemon right here.
Right here?
Yeah.
Where?
Open up your phone.
Okay. Okay, where is it?
Turn a little, yep, right there.
It's a Pidgey.
Well, you know, it's candy.
As I was saying, welcome back to NeuroTransmissions. You've probably already guessed it, but this week I want to talk about why everyone, myself included, is so dang obsessed with Pokemon Go. Why do we gotta catch them all?
Yes.
If you're not playing Pokemon Go, then you've almost definitely heard of it. And if somehow you haven't heard of it, you've probably seen people playing it, wandering in packs around unfamiliar neighborhoods with their phones in their hands. This groundbreaking game combines augmented reality, or AR technology, with a GPS in your smartphone to let you find and catch Pokemon as you navigate in the real world. Then you can use those pocket monsters to battle at gyms and become the greatest Pokemon master of them all. With an estimated 75 million downloads and counting, Pokemon Go can be considered the most successful mobile game ever created. So how did this game become so massively popular in such a short amount of time? And why can't people stop playing? There are a couple of things that make Pokemon Go different from other video games. It's the perfect storm of nostalgia from childhood, social bonding, and exercise. And all of those things are really good for our brains. Many of the people obsessed with Pokemon Go are people who have been playing the game, either on Game Boy or in card form, for years. So the new smartphone app makes them feel nostalgic. Nostalgia is sometimes seen as a sad emotion, like wishing you could go back to a particular time period or event, but it's actually psychologically rewarding. It boosts self-esteem and helps individuals feel a renewed sense of purpose in their life, letting them contextualize their current situation with their past. Recalling happy memories can restore optimism. Basically, people are excited because they can look forward to making more happy memories in the future. And since nostalgia is often focused on recalling social experiences, it boosts feelings of social connectedness, another big part of Pokemon Go's appeal. Pokemon Go gets you out of the house, often with friends or at least with friendly strangers, to catch Pokemon and visit new Pokestops. This combines social bonding with exercise, both of which cause your brain to release chemicals that make you feel good. Oxytocin, the trust hormone, and its relative vasopressin are released during social bonding behaviors. These hormones make us feel relaxed and comfortable with the people we're with, enforcing friendships. At the same time, exercise lowers blood levels of stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline, and releases endorphins, which act as natural painkillers and improve your mood. So all of these things that you experience while playing Pokemon Go, nostalgia, socialization, and exercise, make you feel good. And your brain likes it when you feel good. Which brings us to the last key part of what's making Pokemon Go so successful and so addictive. It's super rewarding. On top of making us feel good, the game actually rewards you for your efforts. You discover new Pokemon, collect more Pokeballs and potions, level up, and win gym battles. The major brain pathway that deals with reward is the mesolimbic dopamine system. This is a circuit that links the ventral tegmental area, or VTA, to the nucleus accumbens. In response to a rewarding stimulus, the VTA neurons release dopamine in the nucleus accumbens, which then mediates the response to that reward. This circuit is also connected to memory systems, like the hippocampus and amygdala, as well as the decision-making frontal cortex. Acting together, activation of the pathway tells the individual that something was rewarding. The memory systems will remember what the stimulus was, and the frontal cortex decides whether or not the individual should seek out that reward again. So even though the rewards in Pokemon Go are digital, not physical, our brains still find them rewarding. And we keep playing because we want to keep getting those rewards. And the game is set up so you never know what to expect, which keeps you guessing and always excited to find another Pokemon. Unless it's a Pidgey. Stupid Pidgeys. Thanks for watching this episode of NeuroTransmissions. If you liked it, we hope that you choose us by hitting subscribe to catch our next video. If you think we're the very best, please consider contributing to our Patreon. We appreciate your support so we can keep making videos about our favorite nerdy hobbies. Until next time, I'm Allie Astrocyte.
Blasting off again!